So Finance Minister Jaitley presents a safe, please all budget. There's something for everyone. I think the focus of the budget has largely been on rural India. MSP has gone up by 1.5 times. Corporate tax has been cut by about 25% for 99% of companies in India. That's a turnover of 250 crores and less. Salaried class gets a bit of a mixed bag. Standard deduction is back. The bad news is really for the equity investors. Long-term capital gains is back in some fashion for 10%. Well, that's not good news. But if you see the equity markets right now, they seem to be taking it in the chin. Lastly, divestment target is about 80,000 crores. The headline budget deficit is at 3.3% for fiscal 19. It doesn't quite add up. More questions to be asked on that one.
This is a taxing budget because it's increased the cess on all individual and corporate taxpayers. It has increased customs duties across the board on a variety of goods. It's introduced a new surcharge, which is a social welfare surcharge, and it's also reintroduced long-term capital gains tax. So whether you are an ordinary individual taxpayer or corporate taxpayer, you are an importer of goods, or you are a stock market investor, your tax burden went up thanks to Budget 2018.
Well, not a bad budget, you would say, from a market's perspective. Would the markets have been happy with a 3.2 as opposed to a 3.3 for FY19? Sure, they could have, but I think they'll take it into the stride. The biggest news, of course, was reintroduction of LTCG. But since it's not retrospective but prospective, I think the markets have taken it well. All in all, induces some bit of optimism about continuity of policy. And that is something that is probably the key takeaway from a market's perspective from this budget.
A midpoint 3.3% fiscal deficit for FY19 and an acceptance that we will not be able to hit 3% anytime before FY21. That to me was the key takeaway from budget this year.
Yeah, so you know, it kept up the great Indian tradition of being a tax and spend budget, and the state just keeps on growing and growing and growing. So I wished this fiscal deficit gave more purchasing power to the consumer.